Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. So one of the most common questions I get about film photography in general is about how I organize and store my negatives. So since this is something I just recently kind of got caught up on, I wanted to share what my process looks like, how I kind of got caught up after it got way out of hand for a while, and just see if maybe this kind of system would work well for you. I think that's the main takeaway. This system works for me. It might work for you, but it might not. It's best to just try a number of different things. I've tried different methods over the years. This is like perfect for me. Now, the way I got caught up was I basically took an entire week and I went through stacks of film that had already been cut and sleeved. Big thanks to Nathan for helping me get caught up on all of this. But it had no information on the sleeve. I had no idea what year it was from, and it was just full of stuff from everything from like 2021 all the way back to 2018 mostly. There was some other stuff that went back further than that, but it was mostly 2018 or so to about 2021. There was a lot of film in there that was just all mixed together. So I basically took an entire week. I would either put on a podcast or something and I would just sit there and go through the film one by one and figure out what was on that roll, and I would just write sort of a general idea of what that roll was at the top, and then I would put it into a stack based on what year it was. Again, for me it kind of works. If I see a photo, I can generally think of when I shot that photo, whether that be what camera I was using, because I can kind of remember specific photos and, you know, times of year when I was shooting a lot with one particular camera. Or obviously if there's some context in the photo, like the kids or something, I can usually use that as a way to figure out what year it was. So I just divided things up by stacks, and yeah, it was just a lot of fun to kind of go back through so many photos that I hadn't seen in a really long time. There's a photo of me at 21, and seeing that just a couple weeks ahead of my 31st birthday. Today is my 31st birthday, actually, when this video goes up. It was just crazy to see that. And then another roll that I came across, or I actually specifically thought of the photo. I hadn't thought of this photo or this scenario at all in years. And it's sort of a graphic photo, so I'm gonna give you like a quick little warning. If you don't wanna see it, skip to this timestamp right here. I hadn't thought of this photo or this scenario in years, but Scioto Trails, a nearby park, it was a place I used to always just walk around in the woods with my camera and shoot photos. This was, you know, 2012. And I was walking around with my Hasselblad and some 35mm camera, because I have photos of this scene with both formats, and I don't know what camera it was. I know I used a flash, so it doesn't look like a point-and-shoot lens, but I don't remember ever carrying a flash on my 35. Anyway, I'm walking around the woods and I saw these two animal carcasses draped over this tree branch, and there was no car in sight. I mean, maybe someone was using that as some kind of bait for hunting purposes. I don't think this was like public hunting land. I was regularly walking around there in the woods with my camera on the actual hiking trails, so I didn't see a car in sight, I didn't see anybody in sight, and I just had my cameras with me, and I'm like, well, I don't know what this is, but it's not something I see every day. So I made a couple of photos with my Hasselblad and Tri-X, and then again, some 35mm camera, who knows, also on Tri-X. But what was crazier than that, like that's a weird scene and everything, but what was crazier was the day that I randomly thought of it and dug the negatives out that I haven't seen in probably around the time that I actually shot it and developed it, was 9 years to the day. It was on November 12th when I randomly thought of it, and that was the day that I shot and developed the film that same day, because I specifically remember going home to develop it that day, because it was just such a weird scene. So yeah, that was just kind of weird. Anyway, it was just a lot of fun to get caught up and kind of go back through some photos that I haven't seen in a really long time. So if you haven't done that in a while, I highly suggest it. Now I store all of the film in print file sleeves, and I put those sleeves in Bessler archival binders. I will put links to both of those down below. This has been the best method for me because print file sleeves are just readily available. They're sort of like the standard negative sleeve, and then the Bessler archival binders are great because it completely closes all the way around. So there's nothing getting in to the actual binder itself. So just for long-term storage, to keep things off of the sleeves and dust-free and all of that, these things are well worth the investment. And then I use this Little Brother label. I wish it was called Little Brother instead of just Brother, but I use this label maker, and I just label everything based on the year or the project. So keeping things by year, generally chronological if I can, but just by year, that typically works best for me and just my memory. I feel like it's easy enough to do that. And if I'm ever going back to find a particular photo, I don't mind flipping through the photos from that year because I often come across photos that I haven't seen or thought of in a long time. So take the time to get your stuff organized now if you haven't already. If you have a system that works well for you, I'd love to hear about it in the comments down below. But it was really enjoyable to just go back through some of these photos. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing some of the older photos. And I don't know, the whole thing has kind of made me think a lot about the lifetime of a photo because there are so many photos that I have not even given more than just a moment's, you know, glance as I was kind of going through the photos when I first developed the roll. There's so much stuff in there that I probably have not given a second look that, you know, I think a lot of my time this winter is going to be dedicated to just going through the archives and just seeing what I come across and see what I was looking at all those years, because it's stuff I haven't seen in a long time. So yeah, it'll be interesting. But all that to say, I'd love to hear what you guys think about all of this in the comments down below. Thank you guys for everything. Obviously, you know that. I love ya. It feels really good to be making videos again and sort of getting back to the basics in a way and figuring out kind of why I'm here in the first place. And you guys have been awesome in that. So I just want to say thank you. I want to give a big thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring this video, for helping a random guy like me pay his bills, and of course for making the best all-in-one service to build a website. I first started using Squarespace years before they ever decided to sponsor this channel because it was just a no-brainer. They had everything I needed. So no matter what you need, it's all built right into Squarespace's service. Whether you need to show your portfolio or run an online store or send out an email newsletter, everything you need is all in one place. Not only that, it's incredibly easy to just select a template that works for you, and then you can further customize that to suit your needs and look that you're going for your business or brand. Of course, as easy as it is, Squarespace is always there to help. They have 24/7 award-winning customer service, so if you ever need help with anything, just give them a shout. If you want to try Squarespace out for yourself, you can do that entirely free at squarespace.com, but when you go to squarespace.com/mattday, that'll get you 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. So thank you again to Squarespace for all of their support here on the channel.